Good morning.
It's very warm, isn't it?
It is quite warm.
I don't think
it'll be warm today. Good morning, darling. Right. Welcome to the office, basically, for the day. I want to cover it in stickers. What do you think? That's a really good idea. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the vlog. It is day. What day of the vlog is it today?
Well, you're 2 weeks.
I know. Sorry, let's see if you can do the maths.
116.
It's like 118.
Oh, go away. That's
2 days, I know. It's great. Wait, no, 119. I'm not doing enough. Just getting to 200. No, I don't think I get to 200.
Really?
Yeah, I was talking about this the other day. What's going to happen? And I don't know. Actually, I am going to know.
Getting some motorbike. Like, and then out of nowhere.
Yeah. You're dead right now.
Maybe he's just like practicing. That'd be funny. He'd be like flying kick into a roundhouse and back in.
Flying kick into.
Or maybe they're looking around the room. Like, or like look.
I feel like it's more in Tom's character.
No, yeah. What do you mean?
Like to the fly kick.
Yeah.
High five.
It's done.
That's the rewrite done. My head looks awful. But yeah, that is our script finished.
Next week.
Possibly.
Maybe.
First day filming.
And the week after as well. And then it's my birthday.
Yeah. Then we're gonna go out for lunch now. We're very hungry. But we finished the script. It's done. By the time I edit some other stuff with it.
As good as we think it's in our head, you're in for a treat.
It's gonna be, I'm a big
Halloween.
Fan of it. Halloween. Hopefully. Well, fingers crossed. If nothing else goes wrong. And there's not another pandemic. But I need to get that edited and sent off to the actors and actresses. And it's gonna take me a bit of time tonight, but we'll get through it. I'm hungry. I'm gonna go for food. I'll be right back. Goodbye, Joseph. Thank you for coming over. Good session. I'm seeing him tomorrow. It's not a very big deal. I'm seeing him very soon. So that was a long and hard but good meeting. We got a lot of stuff done and I still have a lot of stuff to do. You can't see me because it's super dark. And it's 4 o'clock and it's only just getting started. I love my life. Oh, and then he dropped the camera. That wasn't good. Oh, hang on, all my lights are out. I've been having a very, very busy day today. So I do warn you, I'm extra tired. But I did actually want to talk about something today. So that's really important. It's like a question I've been getting a lot recently is turn off the TV. YouTube channels, starting them up. It could be a bit stressful. There's a few things I think a lot of people should know. Obviously, I've been doing mine for quite a long time. I have watched quite a lot of these videos, obviously, when I'm starting up my channel. I watch a lot of YouTube. I watch a goddamn lot of YouTube. And this is what I've kind of found between loads of different stuff and, you know, seeing loads of people build up their channels and see what hits, basically. You have to really think about what content you want to make and what content you want to do because you want it to be your channel, to be honest. That's just, so think about what interests you like. But when you're just starting up your channel and you want to make your first video, it's quite known to do like a whole welcome, hello, this is my channel video. That's perfectly fine. But one tip I would say is make sure you have another video stored up before you post that video. One thing I find is that when you have like the start videos of, oh yeah, this is my channel, it could be a quite long time between the next video. Maybe before you start your YouTube, schedule 3, just so you can see how it goes, see what people like, get consensus of what your audience is engaging with probably the best. And it's always nice to have a bit of content, especially when you start up your channel, gives a lot of people to, one, find 3 videos, you triple your chance of someone finding your channel. 2, social media is gonna be your best friend. Hashtags are absolutely brilliant, especially on YouTube as well as Instagram. Not really, I haven't used Twitter a lot, but what I've found, hashtags are the way to go. Especially if you build up your social media when you're starting or maybe before you start, it's always nice to keep them updated on when the video's coming out and where you can find it and what time and what day and when in the month you're gonna start uploading. So it's always great to have that. I should probably use Instagram a bit more. With these daily vlogs, I found it really hard to kind of keep up with that. But yeah, promote in any way possible. You know, there's loads of different ways you can promote it. That's kind of up to you. Social media is a very good way though. You should probably watch out for that. You know, like profile picture, name of the channel, banner, all of that stuff, the exciting stuff. Especially when you're starting up, it can be really exciting or daunting depending on how you're looking at it and how all these different details about your channel, how it makes it unique. I would say you have to be careful with naming your channel because sometimes it just doesn't let you do it. I believe you might get 4 or 5 tries to do it before it doesn't let you do it for a couple months. So maybe a good idea is just sticking with your name for now and then picking something later if you feel like it. Again, depending on the content you produce. As well as for profile pictures and banners, for me, I use Photoshop for mine. Always think about changing mine and updating it. You can change it as many times as you want, I'm pretty sure. So make sure you get the right sizing. Also, there is a way you can view it with for smartphones and tablets and laptops, TVs, whatever. You can see how it would look like. I'd say try and get something that fits all of them perfectly. But yeah, don't be afraid to experiment with your banner. Ask people for opinions. That's one of the main things. My next point, opinions. Don't be afraid to show your stuff to other people, because another set of eyes can be a great thing, especially if you're doing in the realms of like film and filmmaking. It's very important to get someone else's opinion on something else. Descriptions are going to be your best friend. Thumbnails also are great to do in Photoshop. 1280 by 720 is the aspect ratio for thumbnails. Also, keeping constant themes of thumbnails can be a fun idea to do, especially, you know, expressing your style is probably the most important thing to do on the internet, and a way to grow a following, because some people vibe and some people don't. So that, yeah, that's about it. That's what I have for today. I'm sorry, it's a bit of a crap video, but I've had a very strange day, a very busy, strange day. So I will get back to you tomorrow for a fun vlog. Joseph's in it again, and I'll see you then. So have a good night. Make sure you like the video if you want to. God, watch my other videos. That's fun. That's always fun. I have some good ones, I have some bad ones, and goodbye.